In this lecture, we study skip list. Skip list is a variant of the linked list. Previously, we studied array, vector, and linked list. None of the three data structures can efficiently perform both of search and insertion. Skip list is advantageous. It can perform both search and insertion in log n time. N is the size of skip list, that is, the number of elements. This lecture has three parts. The first is building a skip list. The second is search. The last part is insertion. Let's begin with building a skip list. Initially, we have a linked list containing n elements. The elements are in ascending order. The biggest shortcoming of linked list is that random access is not supported. Although the elements are sorted, I cannot perform binary search because I don't know the address of the middle. The search of an element in a linked list is slow. There's no better way than traversing the list, so the time complexity is On. Since it is slow to go to the middle, a natural idea is to add pointers from the beginning to the middle, so that we can go to the middle very efficiently. Let's build such a skip list upon the standard linked list. A node called Sentinel is added to the left of the first node. This linked list is called layer 0 or L0. Let's build the L1 linked list. It is a layer above the L0. Here, L0 and L1 refer to the pointers, not the data. In L0, all the nodes are linked. There is no skip. Differently, L1 has skips. Now, let's add pointers to L1. Skip list is a randomized data structure. Whether to grow a node's height is a random decision. Let's begin with the first node, which is marked by the red color. Let's decide on whether to grow its height. Flip a coin. It happens to be the head. Since it is the head, I let the red node grow. Let the sentinel's L1 pointer point to the red node. The next node in the L0 layer is 8. It's marked in the red color. Let's decide on whether to grow the red node's height. Flip a coin. It happens to be the tail. It is a tail, so the height does not grow. The L1 layer skips the red node. The next node in the L0 layer is 10. Let's decide on whether to grow its height. Flip a coin. It happens to be the head. So I grow its height and append it to the L1 layer. The next node in the L0 layer is 11. Flip a coin. It happens to be the head. Let the height grow. Link it to the L1 layer. The next node in the L0 layer is 13. Flip a coin. It happens to be the head. Grow its height and link it to the L1 layer. The next node in the L0 layer is 19. Flip a coin. It happens to be the tail. It is a tail, so the height does not grow. The L1 layer skips the red node. The next node in the L0 layer is 20. Flip a coin. It happens to be the head. Grow its height and append it to the L1 layer. The next node in the L0 layer is 22. Flip a coin. It happens to be the tail. Since it is a tail, the height remains the same. The L1 layer skips the red node. The next node in the L0 layer is 26. Flip a coin, it happens to be the head. Grow its height and append it to the L1 layer. The next node in the L0 layer is 30. It is the last node. Flip a coin, it happens to be the tail. Since it is the tail, so the height remains the same. The L1 layer skips the red node. This is the end of the first iteration. Now the skip list has two layers. L0 is the original linked list. L1 stores pointers that allow skipping. Following the L1 layer, we can reach the middle faster. Now, the second iteration begins. Traverse the L1 layer and decide on whether to increase each node's height. The height of the sentinel always grows. Let's build the second layer. It's called L2. Starting from the sentinel, we move one step rightward in the L1 layer. We reach the node 2. Mark it by the red color. Flip a coin. It happens to be the head. So it grows height. Let the sentinel link to the red node. Move one step rightward in the L1 layer. We arrive at the red node, which contains the element 10. Flip a coin, it happens to be the tail, so we don't grow the height of the red node. The next node in the L1 layer is 11. It's marked in the red color. Flip a coin, it happens to be the tail, so we don't grow the height of the red node. The next node in the L1 layer is 13. Flip a coin, it happens to be the head. So it grows height from L1 to L2. Then append it to the L2 layer. The next node in the L1 layer is 20. Flip a coin, it happens to be the tail. So it don't grow the height of this node. The next node in the L1 layer is 26. Flip a coin, it happens to be the head. So it grows height from L1 to L2. Then append it to the L2 layer. This is the end of the second iteration. Now the skip list has 3 layers. Now let's begin the third iteration. Traverse the L2 layer and decide on whether to increase each node's height. The same as before, we always grow the height of the sentinel. Denote the new layer by L3. We start from the sentinel and move to the next node in the L2 layer. We arrive at the node 2. It's marked by red. Flip a coin. It happens to be the tail, so its height will not grow. Move another step rightward in the L2 layer. We reach the node 13. It's marked in the red color. Flip a coin, it happens to be the head. Grow the height of the red node. Append it to the L3 layer. Move one step right in the L2 layer. The next node is 26. Flip a coin, it happens to be the tail, so its height won't grow. We have finished the third iteration. Now, there are 4 layers, L0, L1, L2, and L3. The bottom layer, L0, is fully connected. There is no skip. However, in the L1 layer and above, there is skip. A list with skipping is like a fast lane. Starting from the sentinel, we can access an arbitrary node without traversing all the nodes before it. We have finished building the skip list. The skip list has 4 layers, L0, L1, L2, and L3. The number of layers is up to the user. I can use as many layers as I wish. In this example, I use 4 layers. The most reasonable number of layers is log n. This can guarantee that the time complexity of search and insertion are both log n. The second part of this lecture is search. I will use several examples to demonstrate the search in skip list. The first example is to search for the key 13. We start from the sentinel. Regard the sentinel as negative infinity. Move one step rightward in the L3 layer. We arrive at node 13. Compare the key with the node. The two are equal. It means the key is found. Return the address of the current node. The second example is to search for the key 8. The same as before, we start from the sentinel and move one step rightward in the L3 layer. We arrive at node 13. The key is 8. The node is 13. The key is smaller than 13. It means the key is between the sentinel and node 13. We need to search for the key between the sentinel and node 13. So we go one layer down to L2. So we start from the sentinel and move one step rightward in the L2 layer. We arrive at node 2. The key is 8. We are currently at node 2. The key is greater than 2, so the key must be on the right side of node 2. We start from node 2 and move one step right. We arrive at node 13. The key is smaller than 13, so the key must be between node 2 and node 13. We will go one layer down to L1. We start from node 2 and move right in the L1 layer. We arrive at node 10. The key is smaller than 10, so the key must be between node 2 and node 10. We go one layer down to L0. Start from node 2 and move one step right. We arrive at node 8. Its element is equal to the key. It means the key is found. Return the address of the node. The third example is to search for the key 20. Start from the sentinel, move one step right, and arrive at node 13. The key is greater than 13, so the key must be on the right side of node 13. However, node 13 is the end of layer L3. We need to go down to layer L2. Start from node 13, move one step rightward in L2, and arrive at node 26. The key is 20. It is smaller than 26. So the key should be somewhere between node 13 and node 26. We go one layer down to L1. Start from node 13, go one step rightward, and arrive at node 20. The key and the current node are both 20, so the key is found. Return the address of the node. The last example is to search for the key 21. We do the same as before. Start from the sentinel and search in L3, then go down to L2 and then L1. Now we start from node 13, move one step rightward in L1, and arrive at node 20. The key is 21. It's greater than 20. So the key should be on the right side of node 20. We start from node 20, move one step rightward along L1, and arrive at node 26. The key is smaller than 26, so the key must be somewhere between node 20 and node 26. We need to go one layer down to layer L0. Start from node 20, go one step right, and arrive at node 22. The key is 21, and the current node is 22. It means the key must be between node 20 and node 22. However, L0 is already the bottom layer. There is nothing between node 20 and node 22. We conclude that skip list does not have the key 21. The program should return not found. The third part of this lecture is the insertion operation. We want to insert a new element into the skip list while keeping the ascending order. I use an example to demonstrate insertion. Let's insert the key 9. To perform insertion, we need to first find the position for the new key. That's basically the search operation. We search from the L3 level down to the bottom. During the search, we need to record the path. I mark the path using red color. A red arrow means the key 9 should be within the interval. For example, the red arrow in the L1 layer means the key is between node 2 and node 11. I use a table for recording the left ends of the red arrows. In the L3 layer, the left end of the red arrow is the sentinel. I record in the table the address of the sentinel. In the L2 layer, the red arrow starts from node 2. Record the address of node 2 in the L2 row of the table. In the L1 layer, the red arrow starts from node 2 as well. Record the address of node 2 in the L1 row of the table. In the L0 layer, the red arrow starts from node 8. Record the address of node 8 in the L0 row of the table. After the search, we need to create a new node that contains a new key, 9. We randomly decide the height of the node. Initially, the height is L0. We flip a coin. If it is the head, then increase the height to L1. Flip a coin again. If it is the head again, then increase the height to L2. Flip a coin once again. If it is the tail, then stop growing the height. A new node is created. Its height is 2. Then we insert the node into the skip list. The third step is to link the new node to the adjacent nodes. This is why I record the paths in the table. Since the height of the new node is 2, I will use the lines of L0, L1, and L2 in the table. Let's look at the table. The L2 row is node 2. In the L2 layer, node 2 points to node 13. We record node 2 and node 13. In the L2 layer, let node 2 point to the new node. Let the new node point to node 13. Let's look at the L1 row of the table. The L1 row is also node 2. In the L1 layer, node 2 points to node 11. We record node 2 and node 11. In the L1 layer, let node 2 point to the new node. Let the new node point to node 11. Let's look at the table again. In the L0 row is node 8. In the L0 layer, node 8 points to node 11. we record node 8 and node 11. In the L0 layer, let node 8 point to the new node. Let the new node point to node 11. We have completed the insertion operation. Now the elements are still in the increasing order. We have learned skip list and its search and insertion operations. Thank you for viewing this video. The link to my slides can be found below the video.